Do you want the winning formula to win a Python challenge? What are the best skills required to succeed in a Python challenge? Please come and meet Divya Jyoti, who will answer these questions for you.
Hello everyone, my name is Afreen Rehman and I am the manager of student success at INSED. And today I have a very special guest amongst us. She is someone who has been the talk of the town since we had our very, very first Python challenge. She is the runner-up who came in the competition. And the best part is she beat up so many data enthusiasts that have participated in the competition and secured the third place. So I welcome you, Divya, to join us and give us your precious time this evening. So please, I welcome you here and please tell us something about yourself.
Yeah, thank you, Afreen. So my name is Divya and I am currently working with Cognigent. I have more than 10 years of experience. I'm working as a PL SQL developer. But since I wanted to shift my, career towards data science, so I'm learning data science from INSED.
All right, that's nice. Can you tell us more about your program and your batch at INSED?
Yeah, so I joined INSED in August 2020. August 2020. So I completed a machine learning intermediate. Today was the last class. So next will be the machine learning advanced.
So how are things going at INSED for you?
Yeah, it is good. It is going good. But only the problem is, we are working professionals, right? So it is like we are not getting much time to spend in all these things. But yeah, it is okay. It's manageable.
All right. So Divya, let us know, how did you prepare for the competition?
Yeah, so when I got the mail, right, I was really excited. I was preparing. I was studying Python since long, even before I joined INSED. But when I joined INSED, right, it gave me a proper way, like how to use Python in data science. Python is very used, right? So I was like learning from here and there, and it was like I didn't have any direction, But when INSED gave me the direction, right, like NumPy and Pandas and actually how to do, that data, cleaning or whatever is required, to do data science stuff, right? So, after that, it was like, it was actually good for me. After that, I attended all the classes. I watched all the videos, and apart from that, whatever documentations are available in Python, so I went through that. I went through YouTube videos if any doubt is there. So yeah, all these things I did, and I practiced a lot.
Oh, okay, yes, that's the key, practicing.
Right, yeah.
So given you had an option to turn back time, how would you prepare differently for it? Because this was happening for the first time. Let's say in future, if you get any such competition, how would you prepare differently for it?
I think only one thing I was thinking, in some questions, like it was tricky, okay? And immediately it didn't click me. And second thing was time. Maybe because of the timing, I came third. I could have been the first, the winner one, first winner, okay? So I will try to manage time. And whatever tricky questions were there, right? How I resolve, I solved it. I'm a DB developer. So I compared it. Python syntax, it is much more similar to Oracle, very much similar to Oracle. So a little bit, and I have idea of .NET programming. I just compared it and I eliminated, the elimination thing I did, okay? And I selected the correct one. So that one, I was not much sure at that time. So I would like to practice more. And I would like to, decrease my time.
That's nice. Okay, Divya. So talking about tricky questions, you told me there was a tricky question. You had to face certain tricky questions. Tell me about that.
Yeah. So one question I remember, one question was like, which is the correct thing in Python? I think remove or strip or something to remove a space. Okay. One question was that. So that one, I was like, confused. whether it is a trim or something else, I mean, strip or something else, okay? But because in Java or in .NET and even in SQL, right, it is trim only. But I was like, you know, no, I didn't use trim. I think something else. Trim is not the correct answer. And two other answers I have already eliminated, okay? So the fourth one was strip only. So I just selected, but I was not sure at that time. Later, I came to know from the WhatsApp group that many other students, I mean, they were also confused and they ticked, trim one. So that was one of the tricky questions.
Tricky questions. Okay. So if you get a similar tricky question in, let's say, in your next competition, how will you handle it? Will you take some time, think about it, or you would just, what would be your strategy for handling tricky questions?
Obviously, I mean, first thing, you have to be correct, I mean, timing is the second thing. First, you need to complete all the questions with correct answers. That is more important, right?
Yeah.
So I mean, I will take time. I will think, I will try to remember what I have used. If I have not used it, then I will try to, match. I mean, something. I'm from a programming background, right? So I can, I can be sure. I mean, little bit, at least 60-70%.
Yeah.
So I will take time.
Yeah. Okay. So tell me what all topics that you studied at INSED actually helped you in this challenge, or what concepts?
For related to this exam, right, it is not much hard for me. I mean, like for loop or whatever, functions, I am aware of it. Only the difference from other programming is the syntax, okay? I mean, or some of the keywords.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the keywords are different in, and not every keyword. Actually, few keywords are different in Python and they are different in Oracle or .NET or Java. So, I prepared, whatever videos were available, right, in our dashboard, inside dashboard, I went through all these videos. I mean, I revised everything. Then whatever classes I attended, so those recordings I have revised are related to, I knew that it is only Python, it is not NumPy and Pandas, and time was not there. I mean, it was like less time to revise everything, okay? So I revised all these videos, and whatever doubt I had, right, I just revised from Python documentation. So, yeah.
That is what helped you. So what suggestion would you give to your fellow competitors on what makes a winning formula for the upcoming quizzes and challenges?
So I will say, just don't rely at the last, at the last, I mean, when the challenges are coming, you just keep practicing every day. Okay. And if you will practice every day, right, I mean, it will be easy only. It will not be last day or, before 2-3 days of challenge, right? You can just revise everything and it will be good only. Okay. So one thing, and second thing, many people are from non-programming background. I have heard that they're not comfortable. I mean, they are, initially they faced a lot of, challenges in a grasping all these concepts, okay? It is natural. I mean, when I came after my school, right, when I came to college, I mean, it was really difficult for me to digest C, which is a basic computer language, right? It was really difficult. I couldn't understand why even C is a language, I mean, computer language. Nothing is there like a language in C, So it is natural. So I would suggest don't give hope. Just if I can learn all these things, right, everybody can learn. I mean, it is not that much hard. Just give some time. If you have started, just finish it. And self-motivate yourself and just, it will come, after some time, right, everything you will understand. So that I wanted to convey to the students.
Excellent. So practice makes a man perfect, right?
Yeah.
So what other type of competitions would you like to, see at INSED or you would like to participate at INSED?
This was the first competition for me, right, at INSED. So this was like a multiple choice question only. So it is like multiple choice questions, no? It is easy only. It is not that much difficult. I mean, I would like, some scenario-based questions. I mean, where we can write something. Like second one, right? Second competition was, it was better. I couldn't crack it. That is okay. That is Panda's one. Okay. So it was like, much more scenario-based. So that one will be, better for us. I mean, we can practice and we can understand how I can, we can apply, Python or data science in, real scenarios. And so that kind of competition I would like to have instead.
All right, brilliant. So Divya, tell me, when you got that email that you have won the third position with us, what was your reaction? Tell me when you saw that email.
It was, I got the email, I think it was on Sunday or some weekday. I think on Sunday, I guess. My in-laws were here and it was so good to receive the award on that day. I mean, I was really extremely happy. I just couldn't think of it, And apart from me, my husband was also happy. He supported me a lot. And my family came here, right? So they were also happy. I mean, in front of them, the momentum came actually. I mean, so it was really good.
Yes. So the celebration got, double in nature just because your entire family and your in-laws, everybody was there. Amazing, amazing. So thank you so much, Divya, for your valuable time. Let me tell you, heartiest congratulations from the Insett family to you once again. You achieved this wonderful feat by, beating over 1,500 candidates who had participated in this quiz. And we wish you the very, very best of luck for all the future quizzes and competitions that we would really like you to be a part of. Thank you so much for your time, Divya. And we hope to see you more.
Thank you, Afrin. Thank you so much. It was nice talking to you.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.